Hello and welcome to yet another lecture on Basic Electrical Engineering, paper code ES-EE-101. Myself Prothito Rai, Assistant Professor of Dr. Shubhir Chandra Shur, Institute of Technology and Sports Complex, Department of Electrical Engineering. Today, my topic is Miniature Circuit Breaker or MCB, Earth Leakage Circuit Breaker, ELCB, Mold Case Circuit Breaker, MCCB. Lesson objective: after end of this topic, students will be able to understand the working of miniature circuit breaker, earth leakage circuit breaker, and mold case circuit breaker. So, first, miniature circuit breaker or MCB. MCB is used for short circuit as well as for overcurrent protection in low voltage electrical network, that is the voltage that is below 1.1 kilovolt. And the electrical network that is include the domestic wiring installation, and it is used instead of fuse. So the MCB or the miniature circuit breaker that is used for short circuit as well as for overcurrent protection in low voltage, that is voltage below 1.1 kilovolt electrical network, that is including the domestic wiring installation instead of fuse. So what are the advantage of MCB wire over the fuses? So we will discuss about the why the question will arise that why MCB is more preferable compared to fuse. So the answer is that MCB, that is automatically switches off the faulty electrical circuit during abnormal condition, that is during overcurrent and short circuit condition, in a reliable way, as it is much more sensitive to overcurrent protection and frequency suffer from faulty operation. Another advantage is that the MCB, that the operating knob comes at it is off position during the tripping, and the corresponding faulty zone of the electrical circuit can easily be identified. But in case of fuse, where fuse wire needs to be checked normally by opening the fuse grip from the fuse base, that we have all done in our household purpose, that the fuse wire that we need to check normally by opening the fuse grip, that we have opened the fuse grip from the fuse base for confirming the blown of fuse wire, that we have all done in our regular life. And the life of MCB is normally more than fuse switch units, and MCB is more compact in comparison with fuse. So another point is that quick restoration of supply is not possible in case of fuse, as it takes time to replace the blown wire of the fuse unit. It is clear that it is quick restoration or cannot be possible because in case of the fuse wire, there is time is required in order to replace that particular blown wire. So time, some time is required. But for MCB protected circuit, it is very easy to restore the supply just by a switching action over the faulty side, or the faulty that is cleared, only with the help of a switching action in case of the MCB. Use of MCB for protection of electrical circuit is safer than that use of fuse. So there are different types of advantages that I have discussed why the MCB is preferred over fuse. But the MCB that we have used or we already used is costlier than a fuse unit. Because of many advantages of MCB over the fuse unit, in modern, the MCB generally in modern days, the MCB that is mostly used instead of the fuse unit due to some advantage or many advantage of MCB over fuse. So the another question is the working of, or say the working principle of MCB. So there are two types of operation of MCB. The first, that is due to the thermal effect of overcurrent, or say the short circuit, and other due to the electromagnetic effect of overcurrent. The thermal effect that is achieved employing a bimetallic strip in the flow path of the current within the MCB. When overcurrent that is flows through the MCB, the bimetallic strip is heated and deflects by bending. This deflection of the strip releases a mechanical latch which is attached with the LCB circuit operating mechanism and thereby opens the contact of the MCB, disconnecting the faulty circuit. However, during the condition of short circuit, sudden surge in current flow causes electromagnetism or electromagnetic displacement of plunger that is associated with the tripping coil or say the solenoid of the MCB. The plunger that strikes the trip lever that is the trip lever, the plunger that strikes the trip lever, initiating immediate release of the mechanical latch, and the contacts of the MCB gets separated. The MCB that can be operated manually also. The manual operation ensures that the operating lever of the MCB is actuated by manual operation, and the same latch mechanism that is initiated operation of the MCB. As a result, the contacts of the MCB get separated and the circuit is interrupted. Reverse operation switches on the MCB Once the operating knob is manually pulled in the reverse direction, switching on operation rests the displacement operating ledge. Displaced operating ledge to its previous on position and ensure that the LCB is ready for another switching or trip action. So this is a general operating or the working principle of MCB. So now we are coming to the constructional features. That is, MCB is very simple, robust and maintenance free device. It has three main constructional part. That is, the first one is the frame. So it is a metallical housing that houses the operating mechanism and the trip unit of the MCB. The name that is suggests frame is a mechanical metallic housing, and the frame that is contains proper fixing arrangement and facility for external connections at its external part. The second one is the operating mechanism. This mechanism provides the means of normal opening and closing operation. The MCB has three positions of operation, namely on, off, and tripped. When MCB is tripped due to electrical fault in the circuit, MCB exhibits tripped position. The MCB shows on position if the device is closed manually, while it will show the off position if the device is switched off manually. The third one is the tripping mechanism. The trip unit is the principal component of the MCB. It essentially consists of the bimetallic trip that we have already discussed, circuit, and the electromagnetic tripped circuit. The bimetallic circuit provides the protection against overload, while the electromagnetic trip circuit provides the protection against short circuits. So this is the tripping mechanism of MCB. So we have seen that why MCB is used and what is the working principle of MCB and why MCB is preferred over fuse, and now modern days why the MCB is mostly used compared to a fuse, normal fuse, and what are the constructional features of MCB. So another portion of our discussion is the arc leakage circuit breaker, that is ELCB, arc leakage circuit breaker, ELCB. So, in case there is any leakage of the current from an electric device or an electrical device or appliances, there must be an insulation failure within the electrical circuit of that device. The immediate need is to proper detection of the leakage current and switching of the power supply by automatic operation of the circuit breaker that kept at the source of the current flow in the circuit. The name that is given, arc leakage circuit breaker, from the name it is clear that as the arc leakage circuit breaker or ELCB that does it efficiently. So it is clear from the name that it detects the arc leakage current earth leakage current and switch off the supply by automatic opening the circuit breaker. There are two types of circuit breakers. One is the voltage ELCB, and another is the current ELCB. So from the name it is clear that the earth leakage circuit breaker, which detects the earth leakage current and switches off the supply by automatically opening the circuit breaker. The name, that is the circuit breaker, means it will break a particular circuit or it will break the faulty section when there is a leakage current is there, or any abnormal case is there, or any fault is occurred in a circuit. It will open that faulty circuit in order to remain the healthy operation of the other circuits, electrical circuits. So this is the schematic diagram of application of earth leakage circuit breaker. So first, for a voltage earth leakage circuit breaker or voltage ELCB, one terminal of the sensing device, that is the valley coil, is connected to the main body of the equipment to be protected against the earth leakage. So one terminal, that is of the sensing device, the device which sense the abnormal condition in the equipment, means the rise of current or dip in voltage, any abnormal conditions, is connected to the one terminal of the sensing device, is connected to the main body of the equipment that could be protected against the earth leakage, while the other terminal of the sensing device, that is connected to the earth directly in order to provide the protection. So in any case, say that in case of any insulation failure within that particular equipment, the live part of the circuit that touches the body of the equipment, so it will cause a a voltage difference that will appear across the terminal of the coil of the sensing device that connect to the equipment body and the earth. So the voltage difference that created, that will produce a current to flow through the sensing device. If this voltage difference, a value that is set, if a voltage difference that will process a set value, the current through the relay coil became sufficient to activate the tripping of the incomes to the equipments. So means for a relay, if I go through the general overview of the relay, a value that is set for the relay, the general purpose of the relay is to sense the abnormal condition within the equipment, say a high voltage or a high current or low voltage, low current, any abnormal situation, generally a high voltage and high current. So a predetermined value is set within the relay. If this value that is coming to the relay due to the abnormal condition within the equipment, if it is more compared to the relay, more compared to the set value of the relay, so relay will sense that yes, it is an abnormal condition, because the value that is coming to the relay of electrical quantity, either in the form of voltage or current, it is more compared to the set value of the relay, then relay start operate. Means the operation of the relay is to sense the signal, that is, it is sensing the signal from the equipment, and it is then compare, and it is then transfer the signal to the circuit breaker. Mean it gives the circuit breaker. It is transfer the signal to the circuit breaker so that the circuit breaker start operates. Means when the relay transfer the signal to the circuit breaker got the signal and it break the faulty part of the equipment so that the other portion remain healthy operation. This is the general conception of operating of relay and the circuit breaker combination. Relay sensing the fault and send the faulty signal to the circuit breaker so that circuit breaker can operate, and a circuit breaker that sends the signal from a relay and it is break or make the circuit, it is break or make the circuit, generally it is break the circuit so that the faulty part remain isolated and the other parts remain in working condition. So that's what I have told, that the working principle of current ELCV is also simple, but it is more sensitive than the voltage ELCV. Current ELCV is also called as RCCV. A current ELCV . So this is the general working principle of relay, and it is the schematic of relay and circuit breaker combination, and that is the schematic of application of ELCV. ELCV means earth leakage. If any leakage is occurred, so there will be abnormal condition will be there, and it will be sensed by the relay and it is sending to the circuit breaker in order to disconnect that particular faulty part. Any earth leakage circuit breaker, that is the if any earth leakage current is there. So the current ELCV is also known as RCCV, residual current circuit breaker. RCCV, residual current circuit breaker. So this is the single phase application of RCCV. So this is the schematic diagram of single phase RCCV. So pole that is encircle the, this is the pole that is encircle the phase and the neutral winding. Normally the current flows through the phase and neutral is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. This is known to us. Hence, there is no resulting effect of the current that is flows. However, when the earth fault occurs, the normal condition of current flowing is breaked down, or it is disturbed. However, if the earth fault occurs in the phase, this one, the current will flow to the earth and the term the phase current magnetic and metal current magnitudes will be different. So means there is an abnormal case is occurring. So there is a difference between the two currents, that is the phase current magnetic and metal current magnitudes will be different. That is the magnetic and metal current magnitudes will be different, so there will be a residual flux will be in the core, and the RCCV gate operates, and the RCCV gate operates. So RCCV is also referred as residual current device or RCD. So this is a three-phase application of RCC. So with the unbalanced in the line current due to earth fault, there is residual flux in the core, and due to this residual flux, it sends this through a winding wound on the core, that the residual flux in the core, and residual means there is a residual flux in the core, and these residual flux which in turn sensing by the relay and relay sent it to the circuit breaker in order to initiate the operation of the circuit breaker. This is the general operating principle of arc leakage circuit breaker and along with RCCB, that is residual current circuit breaker. So due to the arc leakage, there is a difference between the magnitude of current, that is magnetic, and the metal current magnitude, which in turn cause a residual magnet or residual flux, which in turn allow a residual flux to generate within the flow within the core. And this flux same here within the core, a residual flux is generated, and which is cause a current or which is sensed by the relay and send it to the circuit breaker to initiate the operation of the circuit breaker. Circuit breaker then break the particular faulty portion. This is the general operation of arc leakage circuit breaker or ELCB and residual current circuit breaker or RCB. RCCB, that is RCCB, is the residual current circuit breaker. So the third portion of our discussion is the mounted case circuit breaker, that is MCCB. So MCCB is a type of circuit current interruption device. So it's a type of circuit current interruption device that is used when the nominal load current exceeds the capabilities of the miniature circuit breaker. MCCB has adjustable trip settings, unlike to MCB, which has a fixed trip setting, that we have already seen that the MCB has a fixed trip setting, but in case of the MCCB, that is, has an adjustable trip setting. So MCCB has an adjustable trip setting, unlike to MCB, which has fixed trip setting. And MCCB can be used in applications of any current ratings in the low voltage range, that is, the range of the voltage is below 1.1 kV. However, the overall dimension of MCCB is much higher than MCB. Similarly, the types of circuit breaker, the MCCB has three main functions. One is overcurrent protection feature, short circuit protection feature, and third one is switching on and off for the circuit where it is installed. So the MCCB has three main functions. One is the overcurrent protection feature. Second one is the short circuit protection feature. Third one is the switching on and off for the circuit where it is installed. So MCCB is available in a wide range of current, say 15 ampere to 2500 ampere, and it can be used for low voltage as well as high power applications. So some of the applications of the MCCB are feeder and overhead line protection, capacitor band protection, welding machine protection, small and medium size transformer protection, motor that is AC protection, captive generator that is the diesel generator stator protection. So those are the general applications of MCCB. So another part of our discussion is the mechanism of operation of MCCB. The basic concept of MCCB as a protection device is the same to that of used by all types of thermal magnetic circuit breakers. The overall protection is accomplished by means of thermal bimetallic strip mechanism. MCCBs have bimetallic contact that expands and contracts in response to variation in temperature. During normal or rated current flow through the MCCB, the bimetallic strip remains in such a position that MCCB acts as conducting switch and is in on state. However, as soon as the current through the MCCB exists, the adjustable trip setting, this is due to the overcurrent of the circuit where the MCCB is installed at the source, the overcurrent where the MCCB is installed at the source, the contact will start to heat and expand until the circuit current is interrupted. The thermal protection against overcurrent is designed with a time delay that to allow the short direction overcurrent. However, the thermal protection operates to isolate the circuit if the overcurrent is sustained from the designated time. The MCCB is also equipped with a short circuit interruption device. Principle of electromagnetic induction is accomplished in order to initiate instantaneous circuit interruption following passage of short circuit current. The magnitude of the short circuit current is preset and in adjustable setting parameter of MCCB. The following the flow of short circuit current through the MCCB because of short circuit in the circuit that is protection by the MCCB, a stress magnetic field is induced in a solenoid coil that is located inside the MCCB. This effect trips the contact so that the short circuit current is interrupted. The MCCB has an internal dissipation mechanism that is generated across the contacts of the MCCB when they start separating following trip initiation by the sensing device with the MCCB to facilitate interruption of fault or short circuit current. The MCCB that is also includes a disconnection switch which is used to trip the MCCB manually. So what we have known that a MCCB should have following ratings: rated continuous current in ampere, rated insulation voltage in volts, rated operating voltage in volts, short circuit interruption capacity, that is breaking capacity, in kiloamperes, maximum fault current interruption, capacity, that is kiloamperes, number of times the device can be operated manually before failure, and the MCCB dimensions. So capacity of MCCB. MCCB capacity is always determined according to the expected operating current of the application as well as possible fault currents. The most important aspect of sizing a MCCB is its rated working voltage that matches with the system voltage of the installation and operating braking capacity. The operating braking capacity that must be higher than the maximum expected fault current in the system where the MCCB is installed. The MCCB must be adjustable to the trip value of the expected current range of installation. This is the general conception of capacity of MCCB. MCCB. The general capacity of MCCB. Thank you.